Hi everyone. In this video, we will discuss Manova or multivariate analysis of variance method and how to conduct the analysis using SPSS. Manova is the multivariate statistical method to be used with one categorical independent variable and multiple metric dependent variables. Manova can be considered the same as multiple ANOVA tests. ANOVA has been covered in DAV 721. The reason we do not want to run multiple ANOVA tests is that it will inflate the type 1 errors and it does not take into account the correlation among dependent variables. We will use each batch dataset to demonstrate Manova. Again, Manova can handle multiple metric dependent variables. The independent variable is a categorical variable. In this example, we have three dependent variables: X19, customer satisfaction; X20, likely to recommend; and X21, likely to purchase. The independent variable in this example is X1, customer type. Customer type refers to the length of time a customer has been using the company service. This is a categorical variable with three groups. One is less than 1 year. Two is from 1 to 5 years. And three is over 5 years. Manova is an appropriate technique for this analysis. To match with the textbook's example, I will use a different data set, each batch Manova. Thus, it will be easier for you to follow. The difference is that this dataset has 200 observations, a larger sample size. Manova has a different sample size requirement than other multivariate method. The textbook discusses sample size on page 371 and 372. Table 7.3 provides a detailed guideline on how to determine a sample size per group for Manova tests based on the number of groups, number of dependent variables, and expected effect size in order to achieve statistical power of 0.8. You can also use G-Power software to get more accurate estimate of the sample size. In this case, with three dependent variables and three groups, it requires about 110 observations per group with small effect size, or 50 observations per group with medium effect size, to achieve statistical power of 0.8. Thus, our sample size does meet the requirement. Manova has similar assumptions with multiple regression, but the most critical assumptions are homogeneity, independence of observations, and normality. We have tested these assumptions in other videos, so we will not repeat them in here. To run Manova, we go to Analyze in the menu, select General Linear Model, and choose Multivariate. We have three dependent variables, X19, X20, and X21, so we move them to Dependent Variables box. As for the dependent variable X1, we move it to Fixed Factor box. Remember that this is a categorical variable with three groups. Covariance refer to uncontrolled metric independent variables that may affect the outcome. If there are such independent variables in the model, Mankova method or covariate analysis will be needed to remove the variation in the dependent variables due to these covariates. In this example, we do not use this analysis. We will run Manova test first, and then we will perform a post hoc analysis to test mean differences or contrast test among groups. Contrast option is for post hoc analysis, so we will change this option later. The same with plots and post hoc analysis options. We select options and check homogeneity test in order to make sure we meet this important assumption. Click continue and click OK. The first result we need to examine is test of homogeneity. In Manova, there are two tests of homogeneity, multivariate test of homogeneity, or box test of equality of covariance matrices, and univariate test of homogeneity, or Levine's test of equality of error variances. First, we will examine the multivariate test of homogeneity using box test. We have box M statistic, F test, and significance level. We expect this test to be non-significant. In this example, box test is not significant with a significance level of 0.069, indicating there are no significant differences among three groups on three dependent variables collectively. Then we look at univariate tests of homogeneity using Levine's test on each dependent variable. You can see that for X20 and X21, Levine's test is not significant, indicating there are no significant differences among three groups on these two dependent variables. However, Levine's test for X19 is significant, with significance level of 0.001. Thus, does not meet the test of homogeneity requirement. We can try to transform this variable, but here at all, argue that given the large sample size in each group and the presence of homogeneity for other two dependent variables, no remedies are needed for X19. Now we can examine Manova results. First, we examine the multivariate test results, which show the main effect of the dependent variable on three dependent variables collectively. SPSS uses four different tests: Pillai's trace, Wick's lambda, Hotelling's trait, and Roy's largest root. The significance level of all four tests is less than 0.01, indicating the significant impact of X1 on three dependent variables, X19, X20, and X21, collectively. Then we need to examine univariate tests under tests of between subject effects. This shows the significance and the level of impact of X1 on each of three dependent variables. Since all significance levels are less than 0.01, we can conclude that X1 has a significant positive impact on each dependent variable. If we have hypotheses for these relationships, we can state that these hypotheses are supported. In order to examine the mean differences or contrast tests across groups, we need to perform the post hoc analysis. To do so, we go back to Manova, select contrast, then select difference from the drop down for contrast. That means we use mean differences for the contrast test. Click continue. Plot, we can see visually how the mean differs across groups. So we select plot, add X1 to horizontal axis, and then click add to add X1 to plot box. Click continue. Next, we select post hoc, add X1 to post hoc test box. Then we need to select specific post hoc tests to be used in the analysis. We will use LSD, Tukey, and Sphere test. Click continue and click OK. In the output, the multivariate and univariate tests are the same as before. We will examine post hoc test results. The post hoc tests show the significance level and the mean difference of X19, X20, and X21 across three groups of X1. For example, for X19, customer satisfaction, the significance levels with three post hoc tests all indicate the significant difference of the mean of customer satisfaction across three groups of X1. If we look at mean difference column, we can note that customers of less than 1 year have a lower level of satisfaction than customers of 1 to 5 years and customers of over 5 years. The negative sign indicates the lower level of satisfaction. On the other hand, customers of over 5 years have a higher level of satisfaction than customers of 1 to 5 years and customers of less than 1 year. These mean different numbers can also be used to compare the magnitude of the differences. We can use the same logic with other two dependent variables to interpret the post hoc analysis results. If we examine the significance level for X20 and X21, we note that the Tukey's significance level for the difference between customers of 1 to 5 years and customers of over 5 years is 0.12, indicating a non-significant difference between these two groups. Spss's test shows similar results. If we choose the acceptable significance level of 0.05, LSD test shows a significant difference between these two. But if we use the significance level of 0.01, LSD test also shows a non-significant difference between these two groups. We can see similar results with X21, in which the difference between customers of 1 to 5 years and those of over 5 years is not significant. In other words, these two groups of customers do not differentiate in terms of likelihood to recommend and likelihood to purchase the products. I also recommend examining the profile plots, which shows visually the differences among groups. For X19, the plot shows clear differences of customer satisfaction among three groups of customers. For X20 and X21, the plots do not show very large difference between those two groups, customers of 1 to 5 years and customers of over 5 years. That is how to conduct Manova using SPSS. Thank you, and bye now.